Pierre Barra had a golden opportunity to have sent away Kolupa 10, their Benenoa international, on that occasion. But that he really could not do. And on this occasion, he put his defense in a very, very tight spot. But Samad Kadri had earned.
Oh, that's an equalizer. That is equalizer. Bala Yahuzi. Yahuza, the man that has been down many times in the match, has popped up to give Sunshine Stars the equalizer. It was a fast break.
Okay, there's a highlight coming from the game between Akwa United and Sunshine Stars. 3-1, it ended. Okay, Bimbo is out, and of course, Austin Okun Akman, he's back. Welcome. Good to have you.
Good to be here, Cecilia. Good to be here, Tyler. Oh, I'm better liar. not bad issues for Ben to talk about.
Positive
but of course, there are issues.
Positive issues. We have a new president in CAF, then we have a Nigerian in the CAF Executive Committee. Fantastic.
That's right. Good to be here, guys.
Good to have you now. Let's start with Nigerian Professional Football League. Some games will definitely be going down today. Big games this weekend. Friday. Okay, this weekend. Do we have Friday night football? No. So this weekend, match day 14, we'll get us talking. Wiki Torres and Katsina United, ABS and Eyimba. There's a big one for Eyimba. MFM and Plateau United. That's the big one. Just look at tabletop. I'm trying to think at this time of the season, match day 14, MFM, you can refer to them as, come on, clash of the top four. Plateau United, both of them will be playing, and Caterpillars and Gombe United, Shooting Stars and Abia Warriors will also be in action this weekend. Another one, Economy Warriors and Ifeanyi.
Yeah, you have Lobby Stars will take on Nasarawa United as well too. You have Ifeanyi versus Economy Warriors. Niger Tornadoes will play against Akwa United. Akwa United, since the founder forms, Austin, I'm sure you're a very happy man about that. They've been winning games back to back to back. So good one there for Akwa United, but it's going to be very tough against Niger Tornadoes. And last but not the least, the game has been postponed actually. Sunshine Stars versus Rangers International because of continental duties. We'll come back to that CAF Champions League later. 1-4 down. Ooh. Yeah, but let's talk about
With a protest pending.
Okay. Yeah, we'll come to that. Let's talk about
the elections.
They reacted.
Let's do the NPFL. NPFL. I mean, which of these games would you say is the match of the round?
Of course, everybody wants to see MFM play to United. What a story it has been for both sides, you know. And this is what we want for the league, you know, when teams that you least expect to do the magic start doing the magic. Well, some people will say we saw the same thing from MFM last season. When they expected to sleep, they went to sleep. But that's what experience can do for you. So now they are learning. And for Plateau United, maybe they wanted to, you know, drop that tag of unbeaten. The moment they dropped it, they showed us that you could still have some bites, and they're still giving us that. Akwa United, we all know the story. Abdul Mekaba has all the golden touch from Wicked Stories, and we're expecting him to do the same with Akwa. They're beginning to find their reading. They're giving us good football. Look, the NPFL is getting better match after match, and that's why we're saying that let's do more to put it on TV, get the fans out there. Every match the Kano is filled to the brim. We keep wondering, what are they doing that the fans are going out there? They're playing good football.
Yeah. Yes, that's the way it is. Ben, which one is going to get your attention this weekend?
Plateau United, of MFM. Course. That's the game. And then I want to talk about the goalkeeper of Plateau United, Alance, that has just been suspended, Ajiboy. He used to be, you know, they call him Ajiboy, former under 17, former under 20. I think now that they are doing so well, they should know that discipline is the hallmark of what will make a champion. And Ajiboy, he said, oh God,
Ajiboy.
He should become a little bit more disciplined. He has to conduct, be a little bit more serious. And of course, ABS Eyimba is a game to follow. ABS.
They tipped them at the start of the season.
They are going to be among the top four and possibly get a continental ticket. They've not disappointed. They are doing so well so far. Eyimba coming up gradually, struggling to ensure that they get their reading. And
they got a good win the last time around.
Yeah, it's a traditional against Ifeanyi. Yes, they are a traditional club side, that the only club in Nigeria to have won the Champions League back to back for the country after how many years we have waited. Okay. And so I think that we have a good league on our hand, like Austin said.
Okay. But what about the continent?
Go there quickly. Kennedy Boboye, 3-match ban. You think that's not going to affect Plateau United?
I mean,
That's major.
A coach leads a club, but not bigger than the club. The club has philosophy. If I love to tell a coach, go to the stands, and then the assistant comes over and does something, that might even be their motivation.
Okay. Well, let's move on now to the
Champions League. In the games for this weekend.
Yes.
Rangers, do they have a chance?
Zamalek. 1-4 down.
My take. I think one four down is going to be tight. It's a tough call for Rangers. But that they got a solitary goal in Egypt
might be crucial.
Okay. But when you play against a North African side, you need your head, not much of your legs. you need to concentrate for the entire 90 minutes duration of the game, because they will come at you. And if they manage to score a goal, then it's all over for Rangers. I think, give and take, since Rangers didn't win that protest that put on the table, I'm not too sure if Rangers
Rivers Elmelec, 3-0 up, they go to Sudan on Sunday. Is that Donna Dustin?
We'll come back. We'll get to listen to Jose Mourinho, his reaction after the game against Rostov. Stay with us.
Very difficult team to play against, because they defend with a block of 10 players. It was difficult for everyone. Only Bayern at home scored early and had an easy job. But Atletico Madrid, Bayern at home, Anderlecht, Ajax, Sparta Prague, Man United, everyone was difficult to play against them. You know, very well organized, big discipline. They defend with 11 players, and then they can be dangerous in counter-attack. So it's a very difficult team to play against. And today our plan was to kill the game when we had energy for that. We played in the first half like we were the team that needs to score. We tried to kill in the first half. We hit the post, the goalkeeper saved, we missed chances. So they let the game go open. And then when we were dead, they were trying. But of my players, they fought hard to keep the result and go through.
Well, Jose Mourinho there talking about that game last night. But some stats came in from that game, especially his winning record at home, not just with only Manchester United, but also with Chelsea. Starting with this one, Manchester United are now unbeaten in their past 16 European matches at home, including qualifiers. They've won 13 and just 3 draws. Last loss they actually suffered was in 2013, and that was to Real Madrid. So they are on a winning run now, especially in the Europa, but they're still sixth. The next one,
they're maintaining the assist position.
Most of these goals, one man has scored 10 goals this season, equaling his highest rally from his previous 2 seasons for the club. 10 goals in each of his previous seasons. Still has a long way to go, and Mourinho has actually won each of his past 8 European home games. Chelsea 3, Man United 5. His team scoring 21 goals and conceding just 2. It tells you that the defense is kind of tight, not like Manchester City. Maybe they need to learn one or two things from Jose Mourinho. And Ibrahimovic, the guy has actually been directly involved in a goal in each of his 4 Europa League appearances at Old Trafford this season. So you would say that's a good one for him. And Manchester United also, they're yet to lose a home game in European competition since the 3-1 semi-final second leg loss to Atletico Madrid. That was in April in 2014. And Ibrahimovic talked about that one. 4 goals and 2 assists so far in Europa League this season. He has also provided 17 assists in European competition since August 2011. Only Cristiano Ronaldo has more. He's got 20 in that. Guys, we'll take a look at the papers now, right?
Pogba is out for 3 weeks. That's the bad news coming out about him. He got injured.
He goes for the prize. Yeah.
Okay, will they leave 6th position after that? Okay, Complete Sport, I'll start with that one. It's all about what's here. It's all about the elections. But another one that will get me talking here is Iheanacho faces City's sack. do you have in Sporting Sun?
I don't want to suck in the Anacha. It's probably going to get transferred.
Yeah.
And he gets some good money for him. And he moves on. It's not a big deal. It's not sacked.
They are talking about sacking. The Sporting Sun is saying, Arsenal tracks the Anacha.
That's right. So would you say you don't want the player? Someone else.
Would that be a good move for Anacha?
Absolutely. It would do well. I think so. But the one that would really get me interested is how Nigerian footballers have developed hypertension in Nigeria. They said they carried out some tests and hypertension sacks 41 Nigerian players. It's amazing how 41 players can't play. And these are young players. You begin to wonder what could have been the cause. Is it the economic situation?
Environment. You don't create a conducive environment.
It's a combination of the political, environmental, legal, economic.
It's also legal.
Amazing.
But thank God that they even carried out this test.
Yes, which was even better, even though they're facing a whole lot of issues. Well, Ben, thank you so much for coming.
Always a delight.
Thank you for coming.
Okay. Thank you for coming because
it's really funny. You're just doing your job.
I'm back.
You're back okay. Fully. Thank you for watching. I'm Cecilia Borgbe. Have a fantastic weekend.
Enjoy the rest of your day. I'm Tayo Salah.
And let's do this again tonight. Till then, in everything you do, remember, keep talking sports. Bye for now.
I'm going to do it like again.